Hey guys, this is Abhishek from GadgetGeek.com, and today we are going to do a hands-on review of the Asus Transformer Book T100, and this is the latest tablet plus laptop which has been launched from Asus. It is running on the Windows 8.1 32-bit version. So this is the latest version of Windows 8 which you can get on this kind of a machine. It is running on the Intel Beatrill TZ3740 quad-core processor, which is at 1.3 gigahertz. When it comes to the graphics, it has Intel HD graphics generation 7. You have 10.1 inch high definition display, and then you have the touch sensitive display as well on this device. As far as the memory is concerned, you have 2GB of low power DDR3 RAM memory on this device, which is running on a frequency of 1067 megahertz. When it comes to the storage, you have 32GB of SSD on this device, and again not too high in terms of the overall storage. When it comes to the front camera, which we have over here on this device for the video chat and all, you have 1.2 megapixel fixed focus front camera. When it comes to the speakers, you have stereo speakers on this device, and the warranty is around 1 year which you will get. The battery is 2-cell battery which we have on this device, and again it is not going to be very sufficient in case you want to use this for a longer amount of time. When it comes to the tablet part, this machine is actually made up of two parts. This is the tablet part which actually comes out once we press this button and eject this out of the keyboard part, and you can always dock it whenever you need to. In case you need the tablet only, you can always carry it around. It is a touchscreen device. You can open my computer over here. Let me just show you my computer properties. So out of 32GB, you get around 28GB available, and as of now 14.4 GB is available to the user. When it comes to the properties of the system, let me just show you the properties as well. Let me just use this over here as of now, because it becomes much easier to use in this way. So let me just show you the properties of this computer as far as the score for the Windows 8 benchmarks are concerned. So you have this configuration on this machine. As you can see, you have Intel Atom Z3740 processor, and you have like 2GB of RAM, and out of which around 1.89 is available to the user being used. When it comes to the scores, basically the Windows Experience Index, we cannot see the Windows Experience Index for some reason as of now on this device. When it comes to the storage is kind of limited. Although this machine can be perceived as a kind of a tablet plus laptop, and it is kind of portable. In terms of the weight, it is not too heavy. The tablet is around 550 grams, whereas the dock is around 520 grams in terms of the overall weight. So you can carry them around as well. The total weight is going to be around 1 kg, which is again not too heavy. But when it comes to carrying these things separately, you can carry the tablet and it is not too heavy at all. Let me just show you the connectivity ports and other things as far as the tablet is concerned, and then we will come back to the keyboard part. So over here you have the dock connector for the tablet. You have some locks over here, the section for the lock. On this side we see the power and sleep key and the volume rocker. Over here you have another button. We are not sure what is this for. And if we take a look over here, we have the secondary mic on this device. When it comes to the front, you have the front camera, fixed focus camera. And again, the overall finishing of this device as far as the tablet part of this machine is concerned is pretty good. It has a glossy finish with Asus branding in the middle, and it does not feel too heavy in terms of the overall weight. If we talk about other specifications of this device, you have 2-cell battery, you have a USB 3.0 port as well on this device. However, that is actually a part of the keyboard unit. So when it comes to the connectivity, we have a USB 3.0 port as well on this keyboard part, basically, as you can see over here, which will give you faster data speeds. In terms of the overall value proposition and the value for money device, I don't see much value in this device, because this device is coming for a price of around 34,000 rupees approximately, and it is offering you the portability. When it comes to the computing, you can do the day-to-day computing task on this machine without any issues. But again, this is how the front camera is going to look like, and again you can do a good quality of video chat from the front camera. It is pretty good. You can also, again, you cannot use the back camera because there is no back camera on this device as far as the tablet part is concerned. When it comes to the keyboard keys are pretty good. It is a chiclet keyboard which we have on this device, which is again going to be good. So again, I do not see much value for money proposition basically into this device, because this device is coming for a price of around 34,000 Indian rupees, and it is giving you the portability factor which you can use on this device. Again, you can, this device is fairly portable to carry with you. You can actually do day-to-day computing tasks on this machine without any issues. That is something which we can tell you. There is no problem with the processing. Again, it comes with the Intel Atom processor. So again, we cannot guarantee the overall performance of this machine, but still you can carry it along with you and you can do the tasks quite easily on this machine without any issues. But still, the overall performance is not going to be that great as compared to a full-fledged laptop, which has a pretty good processor inside with high amount of RAM, and you can do heavy tasks as well on those machines. However, this machine is going to be kind of a machine on which you would like to read emails, you would like to reply to emails, you can do other things like making a presentation, you can use it for business purpose as well. But if you are thinking of using this machine for heavy processing, it is not the right machine for heavy processing. That is something which we can tell you. Now, when we take a look over the keyboard is a chiclet keyboard which we have on this device. We have a touchpad over here, which is pretty sensitive. You have the left click and the right click over here. Again, there is no problem as far as the keyboard is concerned. The keyboard is pretty big. However, you definitely will not find the numpad over here on this small keyboard, but the keys travel on the keyboard is pretty good. That is something which we can notice. So in all, we would like to give a thumbs up to this machine, which is a tablet as well as a laptop. Do let us know if you have any specific question for this machine. We would love to help you. So let me just talk about the connectivity part of it. You have the micro HDMI port over here, a micro USB port over here. You have another port over here for the SIM card. So basically, you can not for the SIM. Now, when it comes to the connectivity, you have the micro HDMI port over here, the micro USB port over here, and you do have a port as well on this device for the micro SD memory card. So when it comes to the overall form factor of this machine, the form factor of this machine is fairly good. It is only around 1 kg. You can easily carry it in one hand whenever you are going. You can use this machine for business, you can use it for casual gaming as well. However, we are not sure whether the heavy graphic games will work on this machine or not, and we will test that when we do the full review of this machine. So that's all from us as far as the quick hands-on review and overview of the ASUS Transformer Book T100. This is a pretty decent machine which they have launched today in India, and it has been launched for a price of 34,000 rupees approximately. We will give you more details about this machine once we do the full review. That's all from us. You can like this video if this video helped you by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.